boy Will. This Monte.
Hey, what's good? What's going on,
So y'all? This small little project is called 2019 in 10 minutes. I doubt we keep it to 10 or less. So we're just going to talk. We're just going to have a big old reflection of on our year, individually, whether it be spiritually, emotionally, whatever. So let's just start it off with January 2019. Where were you at in January 2019, bro?
Let's see. I spent New Year's in church, so I started off the year right. And went back to school, so around that time I found out I got into my graphic design program. So I had, you know, just motivation to continue to, you know, do well in my major and of course in like the school year and different stuff like that. Around that time I was learning about a lot of stuff, as in like self-love, growth, and pretty much just learning around people that God has put in my life, you know? Mm-hmm. And so pretty much with that, I was just, you know, living life and pretty much just learning and figure out things in the month of January. But I was excited to start the new year. So what about you, man?
January, that's when I started working at Duke University.
Yeah.
I'm a Tar Heel fan until I die, but you know what I'm saying? Duke is paying the bills, so I gotta support them from a distance.
Facts.
From a far distance.
Facts.
And I was probably at the I was in a relationship too. That's a little rocky.
Situationship?
No, it was a whole relationship.
My whole situation.
Highly doubt it.
Nothing against.
You know,
nothing against
God.
But you know, it's just sometimes it's time to do something different.
You know what I'm saying?
It's a new decade, so you gotta go in right. But nice. I might just like pray and meditate for a little bit
before I go out.
Yeah, before I go out, and then like, you know, just
bring in the year right.
Yeah, be safe and stuff like that. Have fun.
So February.
February. I would say February was slight with me. It was straight. It was a huge blessing. I got an opportunity to work NBA All-Star Weekend 2019.
That's
in
what's up.
Charlotte. I was a junior NBA coach. Shout out to my boy PJ for putting me on to that. Networked, met a lot of people, saw a lot of NBA stars, and pretty much, February was really slight. I didn't have no Valentine, but you know, it's okay. You know what I'm saying? At that point, you know, I was still figuring out myself and pretty much figuring out what I like and I don't like and different stuff like that. So I was just learning along the way. But February, I loved. I would say February, after February, I would say, things were straight.
February for me, man, I was starting to feel weighed down. You know what I'm saying? I was working two jobs.
Yeah.
I was trying to juggle two jobs and satisfying my girl. And seeing, I'm like, that's like a carousel right there, but
yeah.
The thing that was missing the carousel was me. So, you know what I'm saying? I was like, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to do this while I'm making her happy.
Right.
But I'm forgiving myself.
Right.
So I was like, man. So that's what really was starting to weigh on me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But other than that, it was Valentine's Day. I was like, because it was long distance, I didn't really do anything about Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
We sent each other gifts and stuff, but anyway. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I feel that.
But yeah.
So March.
Yo, that's the birthday month. You know what I'm saying? Birthday month.
March, man. Was
crazy.
Hilarious. It was beautiful. It was great. Yeah.
March is the best month of the year. I ain't even gonna
honestly. Honestly.
March Madness, you know what I'm saying?
But March Madness on top of that too. On top of our birthdays.
Listen. March. Matter of fact, if you're watching this right now, March 2020, pull up with Charlotte. We're doing the same thing. If you know us, you know, hit us up.
DM us.
Please. Like, something, do something. Y'all gotta partake.
We don't rock with you. You already know. Don't even DM us. Come on now.
I got love for you, but you know what I'm saying?
You know, it's just that we've grown apart. So. I'm leaving you in 2019. Pretty much. I was happy, but I was also distracted.
How so?
I just let certain individuals get to me. I wasn't listening. I wasn't in the right headspace. Mm-hmm. I just was not focused. I was focused on the wrong things. I was giving my energy to people who wasn't reciprocating it back. And after that, like, I was drained. Like, I was just drained, like, mentally and physically and stuff like that. And then this is the point of semester where things was really hard. I was struggling with some of my classes, but the only thing that kept me going was kind of like just not only getting through the month, but like also like my birthday. Like, I can't wait for my birthday to happen and different stuff like that. And then, like, you know, 2 weeks before the birthday, this guy right here came up, you know, helped us, you know, well, I came up with the idea. So we got an Airbnb in Charlotte, man, celebrate our birthdays, and we turned that thing up, and that joke was pretty straight until Michael did some things that I want to talk about, but, you know.
You know, to start March off, I have, like, that's when our relationship had ended. I hate that I'm starting all these months off with a relationship.
Yeah.
But, yeah, that joint, that's when I broke my heart. Mm. So, you know what I'm saying? That joint was probably the toughest first 2 weeks of March I ever had. Mm-hmm. Other than that, that joint was lovely. Like I said, our birthdays, yeah, March Madness. You know what I'm saying? I was really starting to find myself again. I was really, really, most of my time was spent reading the Bible.
Right.
Like, because my Bible app has these plans or whatever.
Right.
Like, you can, like, they'll see you, like, reminders or whatever. Like,
yeah, let to it read every day. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So that's what I was doing constantly. But other than that, March was stupid. That's my favorite month.
Part two again this year. It was also spring too. So, yeah.
I mean, April, yeah, that's my our boy Dorsey. That's his birthday month. You know what I'm saying? April 11th.
Shout out to Dorsey.
Big boy Dorsey.
All okay.
Right. Shout out to my boy Dorsey. He the pastor of the group. yeah, that's pretty much it for April.
Dorsey the... All
right. Myrtle Beach was in May. I pulled up for like a day.
And it was the best day of his life. I wish he could have stayed longer. Same thing with Kel, and I could have wished Dorsey could have came, but, you know, we understand why. May, man, I was so happy when May came, and the trip was great. It was fantastic. Everybody got along. Around that time, I was beginning to be happy within myself. I was extremely happy, and I was starting to understand why I was going through the obstacles that I was going through.
And I was still also getting comfortable with myself again, right? Mm-hmm. As far as like my confidence was going back up,
right?
My love, my self love was going back up. Mm-hmm. So it's little things that maybe rejuvenate who I was,
right?
So, you know, what's happening, June?
Got a degree, don't know as much. Yeah, June. Wow. June, let's see, man. June, I would say, man, that's the month where I became a grown man. I was blessed and fortunate enough to work an internship with the City of Raleigh Communications Department as a graphic design intern. So I had my first internship, and I didn't find out about that internship until like June. I applied to like 13 internships and got denied from all. And so I thought it was the end of all. And I was like, you know, like, I don't know what I'm gonna do for the summer. And I networked and God put the right people in my life and blessed me with this internship that I got really, really late. And the only thing about the internship that it's not only a small internship, but it was like a big time internship. And it was a wonderful learning experience. You know, they made me feel welcomed. I learned a lot. And because of that, I'm the graphic designer. I'm still learning, but I'm the graphic, you know, pretty much bettering myself. And I became the graphic designer that I am today.
June, that was the month I moved out of my parents' crib. You know what I'm saying? That's when I took that grown man step for real. Started paying my own bills, my own rent, my own everything. Mm-hmm. So June had a lot of blessings. Whether it be people sewing into me or me sewing into other people, and instilled a lot of blessings during that 30-day period.
Anyways, July.
July.
What happened July? 4th of July. Where was I? At the crib. Didn't do nothing special. I was still working internship. Pretty much that spring semester was really, really rough for me. And so that internship gave me hope. You know, like maybe I am a good of a designer or good of a person than people, you know, made me feel. Because some people made me feel like poop. Right. And I don't know why I don't bring any harm to anybody. I treat everybody with respect, but you know, some people just are your enemies. And when you're a child of God, pretty much, you know, you're going to surpass your enemies. And whatever's meant for you is going to be for you. But pretty much I was, you know, summertime, putting things into work, opportunities into work, and taking everything day by day, hanging out with friends, family, summer, enjoying the sun.
So you were over here a lot.
Yeah.
We made moves.
We made a lot of moves in July, bro.
Yeah.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
My brother got married in July.
Oh, yeah. It was beautiful, beautiful wedding. Oh, shout out to the bro.
Yeah, yeah,
maybe we want to get married.
I get married when I get married. Man. I ain't rushing.
Man. Yeah, no rush.
Gotta find a nice, good woman first.
August.
Shoot. You know, shout out to my boy Will for doing the video for the release, and shout out to my support system, man. Like, I think without my support system, I wouldn't be where I'm at today, to be honest. Like, y'all keep me going. Y'all just keep me going. Shout out to my support system, man. But August was where I officially became
Harris J. Designs was born.
Harris J. Designs was born, man. And
stupid.
I love it.
If y'all haven't seen my man's work, that's chicanery right there, man. If y'all ain't seen my man's work, bro, it's gonna be in the link.
Yes, sir.
It's links to his website. It's gonna be, it's a lot of good stuff. You know what I'm saying? It's not that women, you are worthy.
It's that motivational stuff. We got worthy. We got hope.
Elevate.
We got elevate.
Elevate.
Because yeah, God's gonna elevate, or you're gonna elevate into whatever you do. Purpose. Yes. You have a purpose in your life. Hope. Have hope in everything you do. Worthy, because women, you are worthy. And I got a lot more stuff coming really, really soon.
That's when I released my documentary about my love life.
Stupid. That joke go crazy.
If you haven't seen that, it's also, you know, saying, that's going to be a link too. You know what I'm saying? Thanks to him, you know what I'm saying? He was the dude. He's the voice. What's your name? That was him.
Why are we here?
Yeah, that was all him.
I was just doing what I was told, man. But I had to. The idea, I never seen anything like that. Like, I never met anybody that's just so creative with, like, video and coming up with concepts. And then on top of that, putting it to work. You're not going to find anybody that only comes up with the idea. But, you know, not only come with the idea, but pretty much put it into works and make it look really, really good. That documentary is, like, all-time, like, favorite, you know. Pretty much, you know.
How many documents have you seen?
I mean, there's going to be more in the future.
I said
right now, that's my favorite.
Nowadays, it's too often we get blamed for the downfall of, like, relationships.
Right.
And it's more of, like, right, I guess this is both sides. It's more finger pointing.
Yeah.
Than taking accountability. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, the last one, self-love, I, like, okay. I could have, like, it's two different, you know, it's two different versions of that.
Right.
I could have put the first version out. That would have been, like, dang. But now I'm like, nah, like, it's not the way it should be done. I'd rather take my accountability right now.
Right.
Blase, blase.
September. New semester. New people. Just a brand new, fresh start in life. You know, like I preached earlier, 2019 was all about learning. And, you know, definitely I was out of my comfort zone with a lot of things. I made a lot of changes in the past couple months, especially in the summer. And I grew a lot from a lot of people. And it's nothing personal. It's just like, you know, sometimes you got to do what's best for you. And if you love yourself, you know, which you should more than anybody else, you're going to always do what's best for you.
Letter to myself is basically like, people like, the criticism that I hear from this is redundant. It's like,
yeah, bro. Letter to myself. Like I said, man with the plan, idea put into works. You know, I was blessed to be a part of it. I low key wish I could have went harder. I could have went harder, but you know.
But you ain't, it wasn't
too bad. I would just say it wasn't too bad.
Like, the point of the whole project is, it's like, you're not actually talking to a younger version of yourself. The letter to myself is a person that's going through that now. That's the myself. You know what I'm saying? Because life is deeper than roses and herbs. It's more that you gotta understand why roses grow the way they do, or why. It's a whole bunch of stuff y'all need to understand. That's it. And that was all September was for me. Just trying to get people to understand how things are changing, constantly changing. That like the perspectives, like the people that's in the joint. Mm-hmm. That I know them for years. And I had no idea they went through this stuff. Like right. I was like, this one video that like, had me in tears on the way to work. Mm-hmm. I'm going into work red eyed. They think I'm daggone on drugs or something. They say you good. I said yeah, I'm good. I'm just happy my friends made it through the struggle. I'm saying if you can't laugh through your pain, then you have a simple mind.